హాయ్, వెల్కమ్ టు డెంటల్ స్పెషలిస్ట్. ఈరోజు మనతో ఉన్నారు డాక్టర్ రుతిక. ఈరోజు మనం మాట్లాడకపోయే టాపిక్ ఓల్డ్ ఏజ్లో టూత్ ప్రాబ్లం గురించి, దాని క్యూర్ గురించి. హాయ్ రుతిక.
హలో, హౌ యు డూయింగ్?
ఐఎమ్ డూయింగ్ గ్రేట్, థ్యాంక్ యూ. హౌ ఆర్ యూ?
ఐఎమ్ గుడ్, థ్యాంక్ యూ.
సో వాట్ ఈస్ యువర్ స్పెషలైజేషన్?
సో ఐఎమ్ అ ప్రాస్టోడాంటిస్ట్ అండ్ ఇంప్లాంటాలజిస్ట్ అండ్ హావ్ బీన్ వర్కింగ్ హియర్ సిన్స్ 2.5 years నౌ. అండ్ ఇట్స్ అమేజింగ్, ఇట్స్ గుడ్. యా.
Today we'll talk about restore of tooth.
A fate of tooth is if a tooth is hit with dental caries, and if you don't take care of that caries or you go to the dentist and get it restored in the state of cavity, it might end up having root canal treatment. Okay, if you do root canal treatment, and then you should be having a crown over that teeth. So for that crown, we have to again reduce the tooth all around by 2 mm and make it little smaller in order to get a natural size crown on that tooth. So this is what we prosthodontists do. It's a minor thing. And the next thing is if you don't take care of tooth, and that might end up with infection down there in the bone, then you'll end up removing that tooth and put an implant. After implant, again prosthetics is one which we do. So this is how it goes. That's the fate of the tooth. That means you have to take care of the tooth
initial stage.
Dental problems doesn't solve on their own. You have to take care of your teeth in initial stages. Otherwise, you will end up getting extracted and that's pretty much expensive, as you know.
So you are saying that we have to solve the problem in the initial stage, otherwise it will get so much complicated. So few people I heard, actually that's what I'm asking, than going like 2 to 3 sittings and fillings and all regarding this tooth cavity, directly I can restore the tooth so that it will be better. I heard that. What do you say?
That thing, see, as a dentist I would say things when they're natural, they are good. I agree that implants is 95% of the natural teeth, but when we have chance of saving what we have naturally, I would really prefer to do that, right? Going through that pain of extraction of teeth, putting something foreign material in your mouth and using that, that's more of a trauma, I feel. And some patients do think that, but we don't actually advocate that thing, or we don't encourage that extraction and going for a complete new thing. We don't do that. Yeah.
So when exactly we'll use this implant, and you said another process also, implant or?
Yeah, implant and fixed processes.
Fixed process.
Okay, so implant is one of the options for fixed processes which is used. So if patient loses a teeth, okay, if patient loses one teeth, so we can restore that teeth either by three options. One is bridge, okay, second is implant, and third is removable, which nowadays people are not preferring because it's very tedious. You have to remove it, wash it, keep it in water, and then you should be comfortable with it with time also. So it's little tedious. So next option is bridge. Okay, in bridge you have to cut the two adjacent teeth like we put it like we do it for crowns. You have to literally cut two adjacent teeth and take support of that two teeth and place the teeth in the between. That's like a bridge. In dental terminologies we call it pontic. Pontic is a tooth which we are actually replacing. So in this procedure we end up salvaging two teeth, right? We are cutting two good teeth and restoring one teeth. So this has been used since ages, but then now we have a better option of implants where we can use support from the bone itself, put an implant in the bone, and there is a connection between the implant in the bone and the tooth in the oral cavity, and which is known as abutment. So we screw in the abutment in the implant, and on the abutment we put the crown. So this is the best option and which is closest to the natural teeth. But then we don't say that this is the best one. Some or the other loopholes are there with either of the treatment plans. So that suits the situation. You have to take the way it is. So yeah, that's how it is.
Maximum this restore of tooth will be in old people.
Not exactly. Now I have seen patients who are 60 years old, which have good teeth. I mean, they are doing very fine
strong.
With it. Strong teeth. And there are some young people who are losing on teeth like anything. So everything depends upon the way you maintain it, right? Way you maintain it. To be very frank, dental treatments are costly. Yeah, you accept it. Everyone accepts.
Yeah.
It is costly. So even if you spend amount on dental treatment and you expect that everything is going to be fine, that's partial truth, because you have to maintain it any which ways. You either have natural tooth or artificial tooth. Maintenance is the big part. If you maintain it properly, your natural teeth will be lasting for years together.
Because so many patients also, they'll blame without maintaining, like they'll blame simply few cases,
yeah.
Like treatment is not good and all.
Yeah, so this it's a symbiotic success in dental treatment, or any treatment, I'll tell you, is a symbiotic success. It's like if we are treating you, if doctors are treating you, you need to maintain that also. So this is how it goes. Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah. So losing on teeth doesn't actually that depends upon age also, but it's not totally the criteria. Yeah.
So after root canal treatment, how do we maintain?
So after root canal, what happens is after root canal treatment, tooth tend to become little brittle, and after certain time, the tooth will start falling off, chipping off. So to avoid that and to keep the tooth strong, we give a cap on it, okay, and we reduce the size of the tooth so that a natural size cap would be fit. If this is your natural tooth, consider this a natural tooth, and we are not reducing the size of the tooth and just putting a cap to keep it strong, the cap would be very bulky. So it's imperative that we have to cut the tooth all around by 2 to 2 mm, so that will make space for the cap.
Cap.
So this is how it is. Most of the patients will have that question, okay, why are you cutting our tooth, which is already good. So it's for your sake that if we give you a natural contour of the tooth, you will be able to maintain it well than having a bulky tooth. So yeah, this is how we maintain. And again, maintenance is again the brushing part. And you have to keep the spaces between two teeth clean, and we usually try to close those gaps. But then in some cases where teeth are little crooked and we are not able to do it, so you have to put an extra effort to keep it a little cleaner.
So some people believe like using this kind of toothpaste, it will keep our teeth more healthy and strong. Is that true?
Now this type, I segregate toothpaste in three types. One is Sensodyne, which will reduce the sensitivity of your tooth. One is gel type, okay, and one which has lot of abrasives, which is total white in color, lot of abrasives. I would say we should keep our teeth clean. We don't have to literally brush our teeth so much that we erode them completely. Okay, you don't have to abrade them completely. So I would recommend using a gel toothpaste which has less of abrasive, almost no abrasives, and Sensodyne. Yeah, one who have sensitivity, they can be using Sensodyne.
Normal people can use.
They can also use it, but then why to just block it when you can use other toothpaste? Yeah.
So in case of dentures, is there any procedure for permanent toothing?
For the patients who are using dentures for years together, and for the patients who don't have enough bone to accommodate implants, so here Dr. Venkat puts implants which are known as pterygoid implants, zygomatic implants, and cortical implants. which are even associated with, initially they used to put, I'm going a little technical, but then I think people should know about it. So initially they used to put this basal cortical implants and all. So here also, sir, which were very extensive then. I mean, you have to literally remove the bone part, and if it fails, removing was very difficult then with the disc implants and all. But now sir uses something which is known as cortical implants. He engages cortical bone from pterygoid, zygomatic, nasal bone, and then he places implants in which patients where they don't have much of bone, and that is really a good thing for patient to have a permanent teeth. I mean, everyone feels to have a permanent teeth. So this technique is making people to have, making old people to have teeth and enjoy their old age with having food. So this is how we restore the tooth, and then we put something which is known as multi-unit abutment to compensate the angles of the implant of implants in pterygoid, zygomatic and nasal bone, and then we give prosthesis which is again screw retained, where you don't use cement at all. Then there's no chance of infection over there, and aesthetically it's very beautiful. It's exactly something which is exactly like a natural tooth. So yeah, we can replace it with this technique, and we are doing it since I am working with sir since 2.5 years, and I'm doing it since then, and I feel very proud and good to give old people that feel that yeah, they can enjoy their old age with good food. So yeah, we can do that. In short, yeah, the answer is we can do that. Replace it with the permanent and fixed teeth. Yeah,
even we are also so proud of that. Thank you, Ritika. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
So chusaru kada, idi vaalti dentist special. Maroka episode lo malli kalusukundam. Until then, bye bye.